Children, today again we will discuss some very important general properties of transition elements or D block elements. So the first heading is formation of colored ions. Most of the compounds of transition metals are colored both in solid state as well as in the aqueous solution state, and this is in contrast to the compounds of S and P block elements, which are usually colorless. So why transition metals are forming colored compounds? And the answer will be due to the DD transitions of electrons. DD transitions of electrons. So why this DD transition of electrons is taking place in transition metals? We all know that D subshell is having 5 orbitals. And the name of these 5 orbitals are dxy, dyz, dzx, dx square, y square, and dz square. And we all know that these 5 d orbitals are of the same energy, and the degenerate in nature. Degenerate in nature means of similar energy. Okay, but under the influence of the combining anions or neutral molecules, such neutral molecules which are electron rich in nature, the degeneracy of the 5d orbitals is destroyed and they split into two groups of orbitals called t2g and eg groups. Okay, this effect is called crystal field splitting. Okay, so the breaking of degenerate d orbitals in the influence of anions or electron rich neutral molecules, which are going to approach towards the transition metals for bonding, is known as crystal field splitting. Okay, as you can see in the case of octahedral compounds, degenerate d orbitals splitted up into two groups of the orbitals. So two orbital which are together known as EG with higher energy, and three rest known as T2G with lower energy. Okay, so when the transfer of electron from lower orbital to higher orbital is taking place, DD transition, then due to this transition of electrons, the compounds of transition metals are showing a specific color. Okay, students. So the energy difference between the two sets of splitted d orbitals depends upon the nature of combining anions. This difference of the energy, which is known as difference of the energy, which is known as energy of splitting, energy of crystal field splitting. So this difference of energy, it can be varying. It can be vary according to the nature of the anions or electron rich molecules. However, it usually corresponds to the energy associated with the radiation in the visible region. In other words, visible light can induce an electronic transition between these two sets of splitted d orbitals. Such transitions taking place between the two groups of the splitted d orbitals are referred to as DD transition. Okay, students. So due to the this DD transition, for this DD transition, energy involved in a particular DD transition is quantized. That means it corresponds to an energy difference between the splitted d orbitals. So only a definite wavelength gets absorbed in the process, and the remaining wavelengths present in the visible light get transmitted. Therefore, transmitted light shows a complementary color corresponding to the absorbed color, and the compound or hydrated iron shows the same color. Okay, for example, hydrated copper ions absorb red radiation and transmit the complementary greenish blue radiation, and that is why compounds of CO2 plus ions are greenish blue in color. Okay students, very important point, the transition metal ions having completely filled d orbitals are completely empty d orbitals are colorless. So completely filled orbitals, if they are having so there is no possibility of dd transition of electrons from one orbital to another, because orbitals are already completely filled. And if d orbitals are completely empty, then there, due to the absence of any electron, there will be no any transition of electron from d to d orbitals. Okay students, now next property is magnetic property. Magnetic property, and there are two types of magnetic properties shown by the substances, and these properties are known as paramagnetic nature and diamagnetic nature. So depending on the nature of the magnetic character, the substances can be divided as paramagnetic substances and diamagnetic substances. So the substances which are having unpaired electrons which can be attracted weakly in the presence of magnetic field, such substances are known as paramagnetic substances. And the substances which are having all paired electrons can be repelled by magnetic field and are called as diamagnetic substance, and this phenomenon is called as diamagnetism. So most of the transition elements and many of their compounds show paramagnetic behavior. Why? Due to the presence of unpaired electrons. Okay students, due to the presence of unpaired electrons. So as we move, as the number of unpaired electrons increases from 1 to 5 on moving from left to right in a transition series, the paramagnetic characteristics of transition metal ions increases. Okay, so from left to right in the series, unpaired electrons increases from up to 5. So up to mid of the series, the magnetic nature, paramagnetic nature of the related transition metal increases, and after midway it start decreasing. Then on moving further, the magnetic behavior decreases with decrease in the number of unpaired electrons. Okay, then magnetic moment can be measured in the terms of Bohr magneton with the help of number of unpaired electrons present in a particular unit. So magnetic moment mu will be equals to under root n plus 2. So here n are the number of unpaired electron, n represents the number of unpaired electrons. So by knowing the number of unpaired electrons, we can calculate magnetic moment of any such unit which is having unpaired electrons in the terms of Bohr magneton. Okay students, so why transition metals are showing magnetic nature? We can explain this, that we all know that an electron is a charged particle and it revolves around the nucleus and spins around its own axis. So there are two type of movement in the in electron, around the nucleus and its own axis. Okay, the orbital motion and spin of the electron generate a magnetic field in a particular direction. This is because a spinning electron or an electron moving in an orbit is equivalent to an electric current flowing in a closed circuit. Okay, students. So that is why an unpaired electron may be regarded as micromagnet having a definite value of magnetic moment. So each unpaired electron can be regarded as micromagnet. Okay, that is why these transition metals are showing magnetic nature. But if all the electrons are paired, then substance contains paired electrons. The electrons in each pair have opposite spin, and that is why the magnetic field created by one electron is cancelled by that of other electron. Okay, because the magnetic fields created by the electrons belonging to a pair are equal and opposite. So such substances will be diamagnetic in nature. Next heading is catalytic properties of transition metals. Many of the transition metals and their compounds, particularly oxides, acts as catalyst for a number of chemical reactions. So why are these transition metals are showing catalytic properties? So the reason of their catalytic properties are: the first is presence of vacant d orbitals. Second is ability to exhibit variable oxidation state. And third is tendency to form complexes. Okay. So transition metals, due to the presence of vacant d orbitals and variable co-oxidation state, they form very short-lived unstable reaction intermediate, okay, with reactants in some cases. The unstable reaction intermediates provide an alternate path involving lower activation energy. This causes an increase in the rate of the reaction, and that is why transition metals or its compounds behave as a catalyst. The next heading is complex formation. So this complex formation we have already studied in the coordination compounds. Transition metal ions form a large number of complex compounds, okay, with electron donor units known as ligands. So transition elements are forming coordination compounds? The reasons are small size of the metal, high nuclear charge, availability of vacant d orbitals, most important point, of suitable energy to accommodate lone pair of electrons donated by the ligand. Okay, so these are the reasons why the transition metals are forming complexes. Thank you.